Now I confess, I've been oversimplifying a bit because we haven't talked about friction. Now, even though energy can never, ever be created or destroyed, friction, in a way, removes energy from a system. Now, what do I mean by that? Well, before, when we thought of, let's say, a ball dropping from some height, well, we could think of this as energy converting from gravitational potential to kinetic energy as it moved down. All of the gravitational went to kinetic. But in reality, that's not what happens. All of the gravitational potential energy does not get converted to kinetic energy. So how does friction do this? How does it remove energy if energy can't be created or destroyed? Well, before, when we looked at, let's say, a block sliding down a plane, we visualized this as gravitational potential energy getting converted to kinetic energy as the block moved down. But let's think about that. As this block slides down, it's rubbing against this plane. Go ahead and rub your hands together for a second and do it really hard. They get really hot. In fact, friction creates heat. This heat is another form of energy. So if we start with a certain amount of gravitational potential energy, some of it gets converted to usable kinetic energy, but some of it gets lost as heat. The energy is still there, it's just that we can't really use it anymore. It's lost as heat to the atmosphere. Now, depending on the material of this plane or other situational factors, the fraction of this energy that gets converted to heat can change. Maybe a lot of this energy gets converted to heat, maybe almost none of it. So let's consider these three cases. In the first case, we have an object falling, and let's say it's falling through what's called vacuum. So there's no air, it's just falling through empty space. In another example, we have an object sliding down this rough, jagged surface. And another, we have an object sliding down a relatively smooth surface. What I want to know is, which of these diagrams corresponds to which of these pictures? So in this diagram, all of the potential energy is getting converted to kinetic energy. In here, most of it's getting converted to heat. But in here, only a small portion gets converted to heat. Enter the appropriate number into the appropriate box.